Time to answer and ask the pros question. You clones get to submit a question to me. And it's brought to you by O'Reilly Auto Parts. Think O'Reilly Auto Parts for all your car care needs. Get the parts and service you need quickly from the professional parts people at O'Reilly Auto Parts. Hi, Jim. I love listening to your family stories. Do you and Janet have any trepidation about Logan heading off to Colorado, as in hashtag empty nest syndrome? Sincerely, JL in Lincoln City, Oregon. Dude, yes. I'll admit it. We do. Dodger Janet and I are in fact tripping a bit, as our older son Jake is about to graduate from the University of Wisconsin, and our younger son Logan, aka Rogan Loam, is about to graduate high school and is in fact headed to the University of Colorado. I've got to admit, maybe because it was the first kid and I knew that we still had another one left, I dealt with Jake leaving better. It was hard, but I dealt with that better than I'm dealing with Rogues bouncing. And it's starting to hit pretty hard. Last couple of months with the kid, it's been pretty tough in that we're sad. Last couple of games of his baseball career, last couple of everything, you know what I mean? We're coming right down to it, and then Dodger Jano and I are empty nesters. Like, how the hell did this happen? It's so cliche, but I think some of you old schoolers can relate. It seems like bleeping yesterday that I was cutting out of the last segment of the show because Dodger Jano was having this horrific labor. Jake was breech, and I made the call to cut her. Go C-section. Get that kid out already. That was 21 years ago. And I'll say now what I said then. And listen, don't look at the C-section. For some reason, I convinced myself that day that I was not a good husband and I would not be a good father unless I took a look. Don't do it. It's not something you can ever unsee. Anyway, Logs has been the closer all season long for his high school baseball team, University High in Irvine. Now, you clones would love Rogues. Rogues is a funny kid. Not funny like ha-ha, but just funny. He says and does funny bleep. He's a laid-back kid. He's got a really good chill vibe to him. So the other day, I go to a game, which they lose, and they bring him in a mop-up situation. Not a save situation. They're down like 5 runs. And they put him in there. And he gets the last 3 outs, but they already lost. So we debrief after all of his games. We talk. If any of you are listening and you have a teenager, you can relate to this. So the other night, the kid is lying in bed, lights out, like a zombie. Glassy eyes, in the dark, like this. Just staring at his phone, prone, like a zombie. I don't go in the kid's room. Almost never. And frankly, it's because he's a slob. And it pisses me off. So I walk into his room, which I normally don't do. I love and adore the kid, but I don't do things like that generally. I don't go into his room, much less at night with the lights out, so I can tell the kid is startled. And he says, in perfect Rogan Loam S, and I quote, "This is new, Pop. Sup?" I'm like, "Nothing, Junior. I own the crib. I can go anywhere I want and do anything I want." So then I lay down next to the kid in his bed, basking in all the awkwardness of it. To be honest, I've not laid down in that kid's bed with that kid since he was maybe 4. He's a senior in high school right now. Super awkward moment. And that's why I did it, because I knew it would be awkward and it made me laugh. This kid's like 6'2 now, Logan. Maybe a hair shy. I'm not 6'2". I'm a 58-year-old dude lying in bed next to my senior in high school, something I probably haven't done since he was 5. And now I'm doing it just to pimp the kid because I think it's hilarious. Probably to nobody but me. Anyway, the kid rolls with it because he rolls with most things. And we break it all down. It's totally cool. It's different. Dodger Jana was in shock because she knows I don't want that kid in our bed ever. And I don't want to be in his bed, ever. But Dodger Jano thinks it's very sweet. And I'm knowing Rogues. Rogues, when I leave, is probably thinking, "Damn, Pops. Awkward. What was that about?" So I walk out. Pretty funny, pretty sweet. And our days were winding down. So, while I tried to hit every one of this kid's games, I could not hit yesterday's game because they were on the road and I couldn't do it. They bring him in, bases loaded, nobody out, last half of the last inning, fans are going crazy, talking junk to him, tying run at the plate. I'm following the game on my phone, which is even more stressful than being at the game. He strikes out the first batter. He gives up a knock to the next batter, which he later told me was smoked. Now you've got the tying run on base. Their fans are talking junk. They're going crazy. Rogues gets a comebacker, throws to the plate. The catcher, Alex Zimp, throws to first. Uni gets their first double play of the entire season, and Rogues works out. He gets the save, and I'm hyped at home. I fire him off a text knowing that it's not coming back. Every text I send that kid goes through a black hole. He never responds. He immediately hits me back. I tell him, see, lying in your bed before every game. That's what I'm doing going forward. His response to me was, and I quote, "Honestly, you're right, Pop. I'll try and leave more room for you tomorrow night." To which I said, "Bleep that. I'm getting under the covers, yo, every night." Because of the rain, they have 5 games next week. 5 games. The hell is that? Playing every day in Southern California because of bad weather. That's some New Jersey bleep right there. We don't have that issue in SoCal. 5 games, which means I'm going to be in that kid's bed 5 times in the next 7 days when I didn't get in bed with that kid once in the last 15 years. Have some, Rogues. Have some. It's pretty funny. Pretty funny. So last night, we're waiting on the kid to get home because the kid leaves the game and goes to the beach. Senioritis, man, he's in college. He saved that game. He went right to the beach. So we're waiting. Jano goes, and Jano's not funny like that. Jano says to me, "Go get in his bed. Go get in his bed. He won't know you're there. Get in his bed." I'm like, "All right." I'm in bed waiting for the kid. He's in his car, blasting rap on his phone, and I'm just sitting there waiting. He didn't care. Your kids do that? When they come home, they just sit in the car for like another hour, blasting their tunes? I'm like, how long am I going to sit in this bed to pull off this joke? He finally comes up. He comes in. He looks in. He's like, "Oh, yo, Pop. I didn't think that was Cody." I'm like, "Yeah, no, Cody's a cat, man. What up, man? Lie down, dude. Let's rap." He thought it was funny. And then Dr. Jano got in bed. And now we got 3 adults in that bed together. And we haven't done that again since he was 4. There's your story. Right through the week that was. "Hey, Albie, can we post that thing on Twitter? Can we go old school with that?" Yeah, Albie's like, great story, dude. Not as good as what I did that I spent all week working on. I know, bro, sorry. I'm telling you, like, to answer this guy's question, to finish the thought, do you and Janet have any trepidation about Logan heading off to Colorado? Yes and yes. One, my trepidation is he's going to party his ass off. And I've already told him a million times, Rogues, there is a standard. You will meet that standard. You go to Colorado, you party, you have fun, but there is a standard that I will hold you to. If you don't meet that standard, I will drag your ass home. Do not light my money on fire, son. Don't do it. So I've got that trepidation. And yeah, it's sad, man. It's taken all this time. Like a lot of you parents will also understand this. COVID was so hard if you had kids in high school. It was so hard because in terms of academics, socialization, we were knocking heads, I was tough on the kid, assignments were not getting done, it was so hard, and then we come out of it, and he has his senior year, and it's awesome, it's all been good, and all of a sudden you wake up and you're like, damn, man, I love that kid, I adore that, I mean, don't get me wrong, I always love the kid, adore the kid, but we're having more fun with the kid than ever before, and now he's gone, so yeah, we do, I'm being very, very real with you, we have trepidation, and it's sad, you know how I know? Dr. Jano sent me a picture of her and a 2-year-old Logan. I'm getting a lot of those pictures. I'm like, can you please stop with the photo dumps? I know you think it's adorable. It's making me, and I'm not a sad guy, it's making me sad. Can you please stop sending those, Jano? She can't help herself. Like, I want to turn this around and show it to you. Look, this is what she's sending me. "Look at this precious face," she writes. Jano, and Logs at 2 with his precious face. Come on, you're gonna make me cry on TV, Dr. Jano. Please stop sending the photos. She can't stop. She cannot stop.
Please.
You don't want me getting all dusty up in here. I've told her so many times. It doesn't make me happy. It makes me upset. Can you please stop with the photo dumps of the kids at every stage of their life? Stop! She won't. She can't. Talk with Uncle James. Uncle James Kelly's in the area. Connection's there. I'm like, dude, if that kid ends up on the wrong side of the law, you gotta bail him out. Can be a surrogate pop. I'll be sorry about that, honestly. My bad. The week that was will live on social. But that guy asked a question that obviously got me going.
My bad, my friend. I'm sorry.
For the ones who get it done, Granger is offering supplies and